Hello, I've been an indie rock fan since the mid-1980s when I ran a college rock radio station at the University of Missouri, which was not a very popular station, but I got a bunch of cool LPs and 7-inches from bands like Beat Happening and The Rain Parade and Aztec Camera and Prefab Sprout and Robert Hitchcock and the Egyptians, Sweet Hope, and I got stuff like basic Violent Femmes, you know, and I got your basic Lone Justice, Killing Joke. I got all sorts of stuff. I got Specialties, I got Minor Threat, I got Japan, you know, I got the Dead Milkman. It was like all over the map, but it was everything good, everything you want, all indie hits. It was great indie. Indie, of course, meaning independent now, signifying that, but it used to mean, indie used to mean like the character of Indiana Jones. It was, what a lot of his friends called him in the film. He was portrayed by Harrison Ford in the film, as you recall. It didn't become a second meaning thing until later on when people decided it was too much to say the word independent and the word indie, but I'm doing it by convention now, which is because I am kind of like a piece of shit with his boss friends. But that's how I got into the content thing and the radio thing, and that's how I'm doing this to you right now. So if you're hearing this, then ignore the fact that I said it was a piece of shit. I'm actually a swell networker. And I bring you more independent music, indie music, every single day, college rock, whatever, alternative rock, experimental rock, not quite, you know what I'm saying? Because that is never going to be on any radio station ever, and they never have a few girls. Now, the thing about indie rock that people like a lot is, number one, it's a little weird, but not too weird. So they get to put their weird pants on and do their weird dance, but they don't have to, like, actually engage in, like, bizarre sadomasochistic sexual rituals or rites for, designed to appease, like, the seven princes of hell in order to achieve, like, a semi-yogic spiritual bliss state comparable to Kundalini, or they don't have to, like, take 7 or 8 different psychedelics / stimulants and, like, go on, like, a walkabout in Australia with aborigines about to get killed by strange animals. They don't have to, like, do anything really weird like that, you know what I mean? You can just, like, put on your weird pants and do your weird dance at the basically disco. You can call it a disco, but, you know, you get your ass out and men might like it, women might like it, you know, whatever you like, might like it, but also whatever you don't like might like it too. Think about that. Which is what happens. I mean, and guess what? You know what? Unfortunately, men are gonna rape more women tonight, but they will rape some men. So watch out, everybody. For men, mostly. Watch your ass, you know, when you're out there dancing weird. And then, final thing, of all things, I've never fucked an indie rock band. Now, a lot of people find that a shock. I have a best friend, his name is Sean. He's really shocked by this, even today. Because he was like, first time I told him this, it was probably 91. He was like, oh my god, you've been involved in college rock radio stage for so long. I feel like you would have had, I'd play an indie band by now. I thought you had sessions like at least 10 or 12. But like, nope, not even one time. He was like, how close? And I was like, this close. And it made it seem from the graveyard. Which is a long distance when, like, you do, like, tiny amounts. Yeah. And mirrors and shit. I don't know, it's not like an accurate memory, but I never had sex with it. I still haven't. I've never had sex with any rock band. I was like, why don't I put any rock on? Because I always love any rock. But I'll write it about I've never had sex with any rock band, which is kind of cute, kind of Delta 5, kind of indie, if you know what I mean. And I thought about, like, all the qualities they had. What did they have? Oh, well, they got a cute girl and a cute guy. But the cute guy's a little chubby, but he dresses nice, right? But a cute girl has, like, shoulder length brown curls. And it's like, oh man, I wanted to do that girl in the library so bad, and I didn't get with her, and like, she obviously is not a projection, because that was her part. I was gonna get with her, and I was gonna read her book, and we're gonna be fucking happy. Fucking happy, and I wasn't gonna do it. Man, what do you do? I'm not gonna try that. But what I am gonna do is have sex with a 50-50 good for you. Do not have sex with any rock bands. Do
do not get close, do not approach. They will shun you, they will throw you, they'll throw tomatoes at you, they will call you parents and call you a bunch of names, little sissies, little pussies. I've contacted so many of these individuals, they will not send me their goddamn 7 inches, they're so pompous, the pieces of shit, fuck me, rock, fuck all drugs, fuck all these alternative rock motherfuckers, sons of bitches, experimental rockets, and rockets are okay, because rockets suck, no, suck a dick.
Entirely. If I wish, I'm just like,